Hi, Russian. What Linux distro do you use as your daily driver? What is the best desktop environment in your opinion? What about a video with GNOME? What Linux distro would you recommend for beginners? What do you use to make your videos? All these questions are about to be answered. Hello everyone, it's a Rich Linux user, and usually I say here that I help you to install, configure and use Linux. But this video is a little different. I am going to answer your most frequently asked questions. And surprisingly, some of these questions are not Linux related. But first, I would like to thank you for subscribing to this channel. The channel has just passed a milestone of 5,000 subscribers. It took 4 months to get the first 1,000 subscribers, and 3 months later, there are already 5,000 subscribers. If you didn't subscribe, watched, liked and commented my videos, I would have stopped uploading these videos long time ago. So thank you very much, I greatly appreciate your support. I hope you have noticed that I started uploading my videos twice a week, every Wednesday and Friday. I will do my best to sustain this schedule. So please don't forget to visit the channel for new videos on Wednesday and Friday. Also, let me remind you that you can follow Average Linux User on other social media. I share trending Linux news on Twitter every day. I also post the most important Linux news on my Facebook page. I have also just created an Instagram account, where I share wallpapers, screenshots and visual creation on Linux. But if I had to be present only in one social media network, that would be Google+. So if you want to follow me only in one place, you should follow me on Google+. I have Google+ collections ranging from news, how-tos, to Linux wallpaper and humor. Also, there are many great Linux communities on Google+. Some of you requested text version of my tutorials. I have a great news for you. I have just launched the averagelinuxuser.com website, where you will be able to access all my tutorials in text format. Well, there are not many tutorials yet, but little by little, I will transcribe all the videos and publish there. So if you're interested in consuming information in text format, please go to the website and subscribe for the updates. I'll leave the link in the description. So if you would like to follow me in other social medias, all the links are in the description as well. Are you Russian? No, I'm not. Next question. Well, I am Ukrainian, but I understand and I can speak Russian. If you are too curious about myself, I can also tell you that I live and work in Sweden now. And if you're even more curious, I can tell you that I work as bioinformatician. So my profession is somehow related to computers. What Linux distro do you use as your daily driver? Well, this question is a little bit difficult to answer because I have 3 computers which I use and I have different Linux distribution on those computers. On this computer, which is my home computer, I use Arch Linux, and I use this computer primarily to produce video. So I need to have the latest and the greatest software, and this is what Arch delivers, so I can always use the latest version of KDE in life, and I can benefit from all the new features of that software. And this is my home computer, so if something happens to this computer, it's not a big deal because it will not disturb my work. And besides, I have a laptop at home, which I can use as a backup. It's a very old laptop, so I use Debian 9 Stable XFCE on that laptop. It actually works pretty well, and I use stable version of Debian because it's solid and reliable. So I use that laptop only when I travel, and when I travel I don't want to fix some issues with my computer, and I know that when I use Debian I won't have any issues. And at work, I use Linux Mint 17.3 with KDE Desktop, and it's KDE 4. Well, it's a little bit obsolete, and I was thinking actually about upgrading to Plasma 5, but I wasn't sure what distribution to use because Linux Mint wasn't very good at that point. So I didn't upgrade, and now I kind of don't feel to upgrade because I'm satisfied with what that Linux Mint 17 delivers. I don't need the latest and the greatest software there because I mostly use text editor and terminal, so it works fine for me. Yeah, that's my distributions. If you have any specific questions regarding those distributions, please comment below. What is the best desktop environment in your opinion? Well, I think it's easy to guess. I like KDE Plasma 5. In general, I like KDE. I started my Linux experience with GNOME 2, But after that I tried KDE and I never switched back. I think KDE is the best. It's very feature-rich, and some people say it's a drawback of KDE, but I don't think so. I think you can make it as simple or as complex as you want. And I think KDE is developing very fast, it's been very stable, and it's quite light in comparison to the number of features it delivers. So KDE Plasma 5 is the best desktop environment ever. But as I mentioned, I also use XFCE, because if I need something very light, I use XFCE. But if your computer is powerful enough, use KDE Plasma 5. What about a GNOME video? Well, this question is related to a previous question. I'm not a GNOME user and I didn't intend to try GNOME. I tried a couple of times. I was a GNOME user when it was GNOME version 2. But after version 3, it was always kind of alien for me and it was very difficult to work with GNOME. But now, because many of you requested GNOME video, I actually installed Fedora 26 with GNOME on this computer. I'm trying to learn GNOME and I try to use pure GNOME without any extensions to truly feel the experience of GNOME. So I don't know, we'll see how it goes. I don't promise any GNOME video, but if I manage to like it, I will make some GNOME tutorials and videos. What Linux distro would you recommend for beginners? Well, this one is very easy. I would always recommend Linux Mint. I think it's the most reliable and stable distribution and it's very, very user-friendly. It's very easy to install. It takes maybe like 10 minutes to configure at the beginning and you can use it. Cinnamon Desktop, I think it resembles the most the Windows interface. So all new Linux users, they usually transition from Windows. So they will feel comfortable in Cinnamon Desktop. That's what I recommend for everyone. What do you use to make your videos? Well, I use a set of tools. The most important one is KDE Live, because I do all the editing in KDE Live, and I have already made one video where I explained how I created my channel trailer. To record my screen, I use Simple Screen Recorder. It's very simple and has all the settings I need, and it always works and it's reliable. To record the audio, I always record audio separately, so I use Audacity, because its interface is a bit old and I think it's not a very nice looking program. But it's very feature-rich, you can make whatever you want with your sound. Yeah, so I record audio in Audacity, edit it KDE Live, and I record my screen with Simple Screen Recorder. In my previous video like this, I requested your help to decide on the speed of my videos, and your feedback was very helpful. In this video, I would like to ask your opinion again. So what would you like to see the most? Tutorials on the Linux command line? Tutorials on photo editing? Tutorials on video editing, review of different apps, or how to make things done on Linux, where I will cover my workflow on Linux. Please vote here. Thank you for watching, and don't forget, the next video will be on Friday.